as the world, as humanity as whole, where are we making our mistakes? Can we guess it back, think about it and correct it? So it is only going to get better. What did Adi Shankaracharya sing? He said, Ma Kuru Dhanajana Yavana Garvam Harati Nimishat Kalat Sarvam Maya Mayamidam Akhilam Hitva Brahma Padam Tvam Pravisha Viditva. He said, Ma Kuru Dhanajana Yavana Garvam. Don't be too proud and arrogant about Dhana, your wealth, Jana, all the relationships, the network that you have. Yauvana, the youth, it means a healthy body that you have. Harati Nimishat, in the moment, Kalat Sarvam, the time can take it all away in a moment without you realizing that all this was there. Therefore, Maya Mayamidam Akhilam Hitva, knowing that the entire thing is an illusion, this illusion of arrogance, pride, it's all illusion, it can be taken away in a moment. Brahma Padam Tvam Pravisha Viditva, knowing that, take refuge at the feet of God. This is what Adi Shankaracharya said. Bhaja Govindam Mudamate. A foolish man, remember God, because everything else will disappear in no time. Don't be too proud and arrogant about all these accumulations, because these all can be taken away by time within a moment. So that is the situation that the world has been brought to think about. How much ever it's told in a sweet, nice way, man has this typical arrogance of not paying attention to good things. But when it's given, when a hard blow is dealt, then everybody sits up and listens. So that is the situation that the world is finding itself in. Everybody knows what is right, what is wrong. But till the wrong becomes so overwhelming that it harms you, we don't realize that we are doing wrong. So therefore, I just met a few devotees. They were all worried. And then I said that, see, it's a cycle of life. And it will go on, as Narasimhamurti just said. Earth has been there for millions of years. Human beings appeared later. Human beings may disappear also, the way we are living. We are actually disappearing fast now, under some pretext or the other. Though today there is a virus that is the main issue, but people are disappearing because of bad food habits, blood pressure, cancer, or all kinds of other diseases. So there have been problems, and it is time to think how we are living. Are we living in the right way? Again, Adi Shankaracharya tells, how do we live in this world? Knowing that the world is illusory, knowing that this arrogance doesn't help, knowing that all this can be taken away in a moment, you take refuge at the feet of God. But how do we live in this world when we take refuge? Tyaja durjana sansargam bhajasadu samagamam kuru punya mahoratram smaranityam anityatam. Tyaja durjana sansargam. Give up the company of bad people. Bad people means those who do not follow the dharmic path, the true right path. And what is dharma? To do good is dharma. If you do good in life, you are following your dharma. As human beings, you are supposed to be doing good. Paropakarartham idam shariram. Body is not been given to eat and enjoy and ultimately die. It is given to do good. So when we do good, that is kuru punya mahoratram. Keep doing good day in, day out. Day and night keep doing good is what Adi Shankaracharya advises. Give up the company of the bad people, those who don't follow dharma, don't go into their path. Bhaja sadhu samagamam, join the company of the good, who are doing good to the world. Kuru punya mahoratram, night and day do good deeds. Smara nityam anityatam, always be mindful, remind yourself of what is real and what is unreal, what is permanent and what is impermanent. This is what is going to help us live as better human beings in this world. That is what will make us deserving of a place on this planet Earth. So that is what the whole thing is being driven to. You learn it well when it is being told nicely, or else you have to go through a hard lesson. Now we are going through a hard lesson. So I heard that a lot of positives also have come out. What is the positive? I was told that many people are contemplating vegetarianism. I have been shouting on top of the, from the top of the mountain, vegetarianism is good. Gone are the days you lived in caves and hunted animals. But now we are living in air-conditioned apartments, no more hunting animals. Why should animals be killed for our food? Everything has changed. The way we dress, we move around, we stay, we do our things has all changed. Then why animals should be killed for our food? There are better ways to have food. So why don't we contemplate on some better means without harming anyone? Punyam, that is. Harming, paropakara, what did Vyasa say? Ashtadasha Puraneshu Vyasasya Vachanadvayam Paropakaraya Punyaya Papaya Parapidanam. After 18 Puranas, Vyasa concluded that the only essence of all the 18 Puranas is to do good is Punyam, to hurt anybody is Papa, to do help is Punyam, Paropakaraya Punyaya Papaya Parapidanam. When you hurt anybody, it is not Punyam, it is Papam, that is what he says. It is wrong. It is not good, it is not dharma. Then somebody may say, but the tiger is hunting and eating. What about that? That is tiger's dharma. That is how tiger has been created. You are not a tiger. Are you a tiger? Then I will inform the zoo people. They'll catch you and put you in a cage. You are human. So behave like human. As he said, plants live like plants. They have not become animals. Animals have not become plants. But human being has become animal. Only animals have to, the wild animals have to eat and by killing. Others don't have to. We don't have to. It's not necessary. When it is not necessary to harm anyone for our own life, then why we should be harming anybody? So some thought is going in that maybe this may not be the right way of living. Maybe there is another way of living. That is what we said. Live in a way that you don't harm anyone in the process. Neither by your thought, nor by your word, nor by your deeds. Ahimsa paramo dharma. Greatest of all dharma is to be ahimsa, means non-violent. Not even in thought we are hurting anyone. Forget about deed. I don't know whether I should tell this or not, but let me tell you without telling people's name. You don't go and quote me here and there. So I went to one yajna. In that yajna, the priest told me, Swamiji, they had a yajna going on. They had kept two dolls, two horses on the two ends of the yajna. It is a very specific yajna, very few people only know about it. So two horses, dolls were kept. I asked why these horses are kept here, the doll horses. It will actually, as per the original rule, we have to keep real horses on both ends, one white horse and one black horse. But because horses are very expensive, 2 lakh rupees, so I've got these dolls and kept, and spiritually we are thinking that these are two horses which are as good as real horses. So okay, that's a good thing, no problem, as long as in your heart of heart you believe that you really are, the spiritual aspect is more important than ritual, I always say. Okay, all right. After the yajna got over, he called me aside and said, Swamiji, we have to sacrifice one goat also for this yajna. I tell, but I will do this after you leave. Because if you are here, people will misunderstand. So once you leave in the night, we will sacrifice a goat. Then I asked, why do you want to sacrifice a goat? That's a part of the rule, that we have to sacrifice a goat. Then I told, you get a doll goat and sacrifice the doll goat. Why you want to sacrifice a real goat? This, he started arguing with me. No. As per rules, we have to sacrifice a real goat. I told, as per rules, you didn't get horses. Then as per rules, how can you sacrifice goat? Anyway, I did not win the argument. That is a different story. But see how conveniently man leads his life, right? Horses are expensive. Forget, we'll get a doll and manage. Goats are cheap. So I told, Bali, Pashutvani Bali. What by the animal qualities should be sacrificed. Not animals had to be sacrificed. Once Buddha was going, that's some time in the, I'm talking about Buddha's times, you see, when too much of ritual was going on even in Indian culture, and they're forgetting the spiritual component of this whole thing. So when Buddha was going, somebody was taking one animal to be sacrificed. So Gautam Buddha went and to the village, used to go. He asked, what is going on? They said, we are going to sacrifice this animal. So Buddha said, why do you want to sacrifice the animal? No, no, if you sacrifice the animal will go to heaven. He said, oh, then you should sacrifice yourself. You can go to heaven as well. We don't want to go to heaven. We want to, but animal has to go to heaven. So you are not a, your stomach is not a tomb of animals. It is a temple of God. Deham devalayam propto jivo deva sanatanaha. Body is the temple of God and the indweller is God himself. It is not a burial ground of animals, not tomb of animals. So that is the idea of ahimsa. For whatever reason, if it's not, if it's possible to avoid, let us avoid hurting anyone, anybody, however small. Just because somebody is weaker than us, that does not give us the authority to harm them. In fact, our strength is in protecting the weak, not in harming the weak. The true strong person is the one who protects the weak, protects the meek, the mild, because they cannot protect themselves. It's not about showing your strength on those and harming them to prove your supremacy or strength. That's not right. So I go on telling, this is not from now, from the beginning. Don't kill animal for food. Don't kill animal for food. What can I do? I can only tell. I can't get into people's home and stop it. They have their own reasons. But then what happens? There is a power greater than all human power. What is a human? One day a devotee asked, Swami, I have a lot of ego, how to get rid of it? I said, sit down for a moment and think. Okay, now let us think. We are all sitting in this Premamrutam hall. This hall, Premamrutam, is in Muddanalli Grama. Muddanalli is in Chikbalapur town, Jilla. Chikbalapur is in Karnataka. Karnataka is in the map of India, one state. India is one country in the whole of the world. Earth is but one planet in the whole of the solar system. Solar system is one system in the whole of the galaxy, the Milky Way. Milky Way is one galaxy in the larger supreme universe. So think of your size as a human being. What are you? You are nothing. Even a thought, a contemplation of this thought should help us get rid of all our arrogance. Ma kuru yam dhanajana yovana. So this virus has taught us a good lesson. It has crushed the arrogance of the mighty, the rich, the powerful, the knowledgeable. You see, nobody is saved. But I was saying the rich are more in trouble because the poor people did not travel to all parts of the world. They couldn't afford flight tickets. They were in there happily living in their villages. The rich are the ones who are traveling all around for business, commerce, for tourism, entertainment. They are the ones who are suffering. So in a way, it is a wake-up call. But take look at the positive side of things. Yes, the negative side is there. People are losing lives and we should feel sorry for that and we should pray for that. We cannot just say it's their karma and then keep quiet. That is not right. Then that is our karma that we did not pray for them. Well, let us pray that people understand how to deal with it. Let us pray that a medicine, a cure comes up quickly which helps those who are in need. But more importantly, let us pray that we all start living as human beings. Humanity, the compassion, the kindness should drive our lives. Kindness to everyone. Jiva Karunya, even for a small ant, there should be compassion. And for our pleasure, let us not be causing harm to anyone. See, if I would be very happy if this whole episode turns at least half the world into vegetarianism, I'll be very, very happy. I was told, because I keep getting update from all the people who are so concerned about my health more than anybody else. Swami, don't go here, don't meet these people, go to any country. I said, all right, they are telling me that now there is a general, governments are closing down such kind of places where animals are sold for food. There is a big business. It's been closed down because of the fear of this. I said, that is Mother Nature's way of balancing itself. We all have read in science, kada, how balance of nature happens. of that ecology. When grass grows too much, then deer appear on the scene, they eat all the grass. When deer grow too much, the lions come and eat up the deer. When deers get over, lions starve and die, then grass grows again. So the nature knows how to balance itself. So it will know how to balance itself. We are nothing in front of the force of nature. So Mahakuru, Dhanajana Yauvana Garvam, that we can control. All our knowledge, all our wealth, all the stock markets, all the military equipments, nothing could stand one small virus which is not even seen to the eye. Look at that. Look at the irony. It's not a huge military setup that we are fighting against. It's not some aliens that we are fighting against. It's not the highest technological warfare that is going on. It is one tiny virus unseen that has changed the perspective. All our wealth, all our knowledge, all our military might, nothing is able to stand this. The only thing that will stand is if we change ourselves and become better human beings. That alone will save the human race. Otherwise, we have to learn our lessons the hard way. For this generation, which has never seen a pandemic, this generation thinks life goes on and on and on, on tabs and TVs. They don't realize that there is the other side to life too. And for them, it's a great, great episode, because some children are asking, why did this virus come? And somebody answered, because it has come from animals. Why did animal virus get into humans? Because we ate those animals. Oh, why did we eat animals? It's not good that to eat animals. Yes, it is not good to eat those animals. So our generation has learnt a new lesson. Oh, we should not eat animals because we can get this virus, at least out of fear. They have learnt that they have to remain clean, remain hygienic. We should be concerned about each other. Just because we are sitting on one end of the boat, and the hole is on the other end, we cannot sit happy. That is the other end of the boat. Hole is a hole in the boat. Everybody will sink. Today one country has suffered, everybody is suffering. Isn't it why our culture prayed, Samasta Loka Sukhino Bhavantu? Because they knew, if I play for my happiness alone, I cannot be happy. Only when the whole world is happy, can I be happy. Today is that, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramayah, when we pray. Let everybody be healthy. Why? Because everybody's health is going to affect our health. If somebody is unhealthy in some country, in some corner, today or tomorrow that thing will come to us too. This is the greatest. That is why our culture prayed, Sarve Bhavantu Sukhinah, Sarve Santu Niramaya, Sarve Bhadrani Paschantu. Only if you do Sukhinah, if everybody leads happy lives, healthy lives, and does what is good everywhere, can there be Ma Kaschid Dukkha Maapnyad? Nobody will have any sorrow. Sorrow of that little ant also is a sorrow. In Mahabharata, Vyasa was in a very difficult situation because both sides were his family only. The Kauravas are also his, Pandavas are also his. So the war was going to begin and he was rushing to sit and watch what's going to happen. And that time as he was passing, a small insect was crawling and running very fast. And Vyasa stopped and asked that insect, "Why are you running so fast?" "Oh, you don't know, Arjuna's chariot is going to pass this way. I may get crushed under the chariot." And Vyasa laughed and said, "What if you die? How does it matter even if you die? Who is going to cry if you die?" And the insect got very angry. He told Vedavyasa, "You think you only have a family, you only have a wife and children. I also have my wife, I have children. They're waiting for me at home. How can you demean me like this?" Then Vyasa realized, this is the Ahara Nidra Bhayamaitunancha Samanyametat Pashubir Naranam. These four things are common. Ahara, to eat to your taste. Nidra, sleep is restfully. Bhaya, fear of death. Maituna, to reproduce. These are common between animals and men. They also have a family, wife, children. They need to eat, sleep. They are afraid of death and diseases and dangers. If that is all that human beings we are doing, we are no better than animals. Dharmo hi tesham adhiko visheshah, dharmo vihinam pashubhit samana. So those who follow dharma alone are human beings, all others are not. Today unfortunately everybody is following their dharma. Even an insect in cow dung also follows his dharma of doing what it needs to do to further turn that cow dung into manure. But we as human beings have forgotten our dharma. And that is why dharmo vihinam pashubhit samana also we should not say, because that's an insult to the pashus who are actually following more dharma than us. We are not following our dharma. And that is where we are suffering. There are many kinds of suffering. This is one kind that we are suffering. But this is a good wake-up call. While we pray for everybody's welfare, definitely prayers have the power to change people's minds, attitudes, to purify the place, to protect. So pray sincerely. Whoever it might be, whether they did right or wrong, it is immaterial. They are suffering today, we must pray for their welfare. That should be our attitude, first. Second thing, you be cautious. You don't do things which will lead you to such kind of things. You be careful, you be cautious. What you eat, where you go, whom you meet, what you see, what you hear, taste, touch, smell, everything is food. Not just animals are food. What you hear is food. What you see is food. What you touch is food. What you smell is food. What you taste is food. So be careful about whatever goes inside you. Because this virus may be a physical, biological virus. There are so many other viruses that get inside through our ears by listening to the wrong thing, by listening to gossips, by listening to false rumors. That is also a virus that destroys us. By seeing wrong, by touching wrong, all these are kind of diseases that get inside us. So we must protect ourselves from all those diseases also, not just blame on the food that we eat through our mouths. So, Chaja Durjana Sansargam, Bhaja Sadhu Samagamam, Kuru Punya Mahoratram, Smaranitya Manityatam. Don't be too positive about the things of this world. You can't take one thing back with you. Alexander the Great, when he left, he told, keep my both hands out of the coffin so that everybody sees that though I have conquered the world, I'm going empty-handed. So don't harm anyone for the sake of your own greed. That's why I said the worst virus than coronavirus is the greed virus, which has spread so badly that people are not able to think. So much talk about this virus because it is hurting the rich. Hunger is hurting the poor. Thousands die every day because of hunger. For that, food is there. Coronavirus does not have a medicine, but hunger has a medicine called food. What are we doing about it? Are we even talking about it? There are hundreds of thousands, even when we visited the hospital, every year 250,000 children in India are born with congenital heart diseases. And the reason for it is largely anemic mothers, malnutrition, poorly formed children in the womb. And we are doing something about it. That is definitely far more number than these 8,000 who have died or 1.5 lakh people who have been diagnosed. It is far bigger number, isn't it? In just one country like India, 2,50,000 children are born every year. Not even 25,000 get their treatment. The rest all are doomed to die today or tomorrow. And year after year, this number gets piled up. 2.5 lakh, 2.5 lakh. There are millions of children in India who are living with heart problems, who cannot walk, who cannot talk, who cannot speak, who cannot go to school, who cannot do anything. And what have we done about it as governments, as society, as intellectuals, as individuals? How much have we paid attention to something like that? What I'm saying is that there are many, many more problems in the world because of our own doing, our own mistake, of our greed, our selfishness has caused this problem in the world. Unfortunately, we don't talk about them because they are poor people's problem. And this coronavirus is, whichever way you call it, it is a rich people's problem. Rich in the sense, this is not for those who are below poverty line. These are definitely for people who are above poverty line, who are going around meeting people, doing what? Whatever they need to. So the world needs far bigger rethinking. Every human must go back within. This is a good time to get into thinking where I am going right and wrong as a human, as a family, as a society, as a country, and as the world, as humanity as whole. Where are we making our mistakes? Can we guess it back, think about it and correct it? So it is only going to get better. I think it is definitely better. Somebody told me, Swami, there is no pollution. The pollution level of the world has come down drastically because everybody is at home. The environment is becoming better because we are not harming anyone. The bushfires in Australia have disappeared because the temperature has come down because no pollution for so many days. So all things are improving. So there is a positive side to it also. And most important positive side is if we learn our lesson as human beings and not do wrong anymore for the sake of our pleasure, let us not harm anyone. However small that harm may be, it is a harm to them. And therefore, not harming nature, not harming animals, not harming other human beings, not harming the weak, the poor, the helpless for our own benefit should be the way of a human being. That is the dharma. And dharayati iti dharma. Only that which bears this whole earth is dharma. And that dharma when it goes, dharmo rakshati rakshitaha, dharma, the one who protects dharma is protected by dharma. The one who harms dharma, ato hanta, dharma only will harm them. That is the rule of the universe. Nobody can change it, not even God can change that rule. So let us be conscious as human beings that we have far greater responsibility to lead a good life in this planet, on this planet, and help everyone and not harm anyone for our own sake. If we begin there, definitely a generation or two down the line, humanity will look much better than what it is today. Let us leave behind that kind of a legacy for our coming generations to lead a pure life, good life, a life full of non-violence, a life with compassion and kindness for every creature. Let that be the lesson from this. So this is a path, some people are very afraid, this is just a cycle. It will come, it will go up, it will go down, and thousands of such cycles have come and gone for the earth. So it's not going to change much of it. This may harm a few people's interests, and that is sad, but we cannot help it because that is a lesson that has to be learnt. We all will learn this lesson together. That should be our way. So once again, praying for welfare of all. Sarve bhavantu sukhinaha. Sarve santu niramaya. Sarve bhadrani paschantu. Ma kaschit dukkham apnuyat. With this prayer, we should daily think this way, pray this way, and I'm sure these problems will disappear in no time, but definitely the lessons should remain with us forever.